Shannon, I know you mentioned before this that you want to see more people turn out to watch you all play. Are you happy by what you saw tonight?
Just like that. My voice is really hoarse right now, born on the field. The rhythm section was really good tonight. I wanted to dance on the field. But everything in order, everything was on time. This association was really spot on with the organization of everything. The treatment we received at the dressing rooms and the cleaners, the security, everything was just spot on. We just want to thank the association and the CFU for a good organization.
Now, has that motivated you all to perform better with the sort of treatment that you all received being in the finals and getting the kind of respect that you all got? Does that motivate you?
Definitely. We just look for that continued support because that is kind of our drive to go forward and play and to play as a team. Players, individual players, you know, to represent our country, our families, and our friends. And once we get that continued support, I guarantee you that Trinidad could qualify for our World Cup, which will be held in New Zealand in 2015.
Further questions?
Jerry, guys, as international coach, the men have won, and they continue to win. What do you think are the expectations on the men now, the tournament coming up?
In October, the senior team will be the vying for a spot in the final, you know, and believe we'll have the best possible team to represent us come October.
What is the situation with that team now? Are you going to go into training soon?
Yes, that team will be going into training soon. You know, we're now finalizing some stuff, and by next week, the team will be.
Coach, were there any special tactical adjustments for the final?
Yeah, you know, we watch Cuba play, you know, the strength rallies, the two center midfielders, you know, I mean Haiti, sorry, I apologize, right? So what we did, you know, we tried to close them down as soon as get behind them, because when we analyze the games that they played, they never really, nobody never really pressured the back four. So we tried to, you know, close them, squeeze them to the center of the park and get the balls to the side of the park, and, you know, we get results.
Now I heard comments made about Levi Garcia going forward, he's excellent, but he has to do more behind the ball. Were you happy by the work that you saw him do tonight, defensively as well?
Well, you know, at Levi's age, he's still, you know, he's still young, he's still grown, mature as a player. You know, he still has some work to be done, and we just hope, you know, he keeps his feet on the ground.
What about the performance of Corbin?
As I said, Corbin, you know, is a special player. You know, you know, he scores goals, he's really a number 10, but we use him as a number 9. You know, he's a guy that we're looking, you know, to bring him up to the senior team, we train and score, and we see play from him.
What's the next step now for this team? I mean, you qualify for CONCACAF now, you know, what's next?
Well, as soon as, you know, we'll sit down with the association and plan out the preparation for this team to take them forward.
Ideally, what would you like the preparation to be?
Well, don't tell me about that right now. in a few weeks, you know, we'll want to be the first time.
Sean, what's your favorite part of this tournament?
Favorite part of this tournament, for me personally, was the night. Stepping onto the pitch, you know, half time, everybody was like, had something to say to each other, and, you know, we just came in the room and everybody was, you know, just quiet and, you know, mix and match the puzzles and the pieces to come out and give a good second half and a good showing in the second half. For me, this is a game of the tournament, and all the other games that we have played, we haven't settled as fast, you know, we've been coming from behind, getting soft goals, you know, and before the game, we were told, do not get any sort of the early goals and try to come from behind, because Haiti's set up and their speed, you're not going to get another chance if you go down civilly. So, you know, that was our instructions, and I think we carried out well.
Well, Humphrey, you said you got the opportunity to come on tonight, and what do you thought, you know, about the opportunity and you battling for that spot in the middle, you know?
Well, first of all, I want to thank the coach for allowing me the opportunity to come and represent my country. I want to thank the players for the fight, showing the fight out there for Trinidad to be going. I want to thank the supporters for the support, and yeah.
Sitting here on a tank and taking place in the Shannon, tell us, a former national captain of the Olympic team to the 2009-20 World Cup, he said that he feels that this team is better individually than that squad. How do you feel about that? Does it put pressure on the team now to deliver the goods in the CONCACAF stage? Well, that's a very heavy jersey to wear because players, you know, some players are new to the national setup, and we just hope that they hit the ground running and they just come out as ideal national players, you know. So I think that the new players coming into the team, that they've set in really well, and even Hakshaw, Akeem Humphrey, some of just to name a few, and Dwayne Market, you know, he was very instrumental in, you know, talking to me before games and telling me, you know, you gotta get them together, you gotta call a team meeting, let them know what's up, or let them know what they're going into. The new, and mostly new players I was speaking to, because some of the under 17 players, they're familiar with this kind of tournament, they know what to expect. They know the speed of teams, they know what to do when they go there. But you know, I was just following by his instructions, co-captaining me, and you know, I just took the instructions and helped the team out brilliantly.
Hey, coach, what would you like to see of the players between now and the Cup campaign? Would you like them to, as much as possible, play for the club, the club, the man that is for the teams? What would you like to see of them individually between now and the Cup campaign?
Yeah, well, as I said before, you know, the players we have here now, you know, we like to see them play at the highest level, you know, which is the Pro League, itself, at least the semi-pro, because the standard of football we going into in the conqueror phase, it wouldn't be easy. We have a couple of players who went on scholarship, was with the previous under 17 team. You know, we looking at, as I said before, it open. So the players, once they have the ability, we welcome them with open hands.
Coach, this is another accolade that you have won, right? Do you see yourself surpassing Gally Cummins or Peter Sinclair anytime in the near future?
That is a tough question, you know. These guys is really icons, the Trinidad and Tobago football, you know. More or less, as I said, you know, it's a tough. I idolize these guys, you know, Gary and Butel. Butel was the coach that brought me onto the national team at age 19, senior team, you know. So I always have respect for Sinclair.
Well, just to upgrade that question, though, how would you rate this, you know, list of accomplishments so far? I remember you're the coach of the Joe Public team that won 5 titles or 6 titles in one season, and all your accomplishments you have. How would you rate this success tonight?
Well, I know it was one, it was a special one. It reminded me of the game against, I believe it was a Big Six, no, Toyota Cup. You know, against Caledonia, where we did won 4 titles, and that was the last title. The guys were more or less tired, you know, they went out there and really fought, and that victory, you know, it could match with this victory here tonight.
Derek, I've received information today that some of your opponents in CONCACAF have been looking at this team, particularly this game tonight, the fact that it was streamed online or globally. What are your plans on to see the rest of CONCACAF between now and January?
Well, you know, we will sit down as a staff, you know, and analyze, try to get games with all the other teams what qualify for the CONCACAF phase, you know, because at the end of the day, you know, you had to work, you had to do your homework as a coach. So now the job now starts, and we will be analyzing those teams.
Any closing questions? All right, gentlemen, thank you so much, and good luck to the PC.